some media days?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm enjoying it, you know. So football's about to start again, you know, so I'm excited about it and ready to have fun with it.
We'll open for questions.
Kingsley, since Jimbo got hired, it seems like all anybody's talking about is the money and his contract. How do you guys deal with that as players?
You know, we're not really worried about that. Because, you know, he's a great coach. He's won a championship before. That's proven track record. He's a coach that wants you to be great. You know, he demands excellence. You know, he wants you to be the best player you can be physically and mentally. So that's not what we're really worried about.
We'll go back here in the back.
What's been the difference right here? What's been the difference with Coach Elko? We've heard a lot about his toughness at his previous stops, and I'm curious about schematically on the field and practice. What's been the difference with Coach Elko?
He's a really good teacher, of the game. He wants you to know where you're doing, really know what you're doing. You know, he wants you to make sure you're in the right spots. You know what's about to happen. You know, so he just wants you to be prepared really well. So he's a really good teacher of the game.
Questions? Raise your hand, and we'll get a microphone to you. Right down here in front. She's coming.
What's been the biggest adjustment you've had to make with a new coaching staff coming in this year?
It really hasn't been a bad adjustment for us, you know, because the coaches have done a great job of teaching us a new scheme and new stuff that we have to learn. So we're buying into everything they tell us to do, and we're taking it from there.
We'll go back here.
Hey, Kingsley. What is Jimbo Fisher like? What's he like to be around? What energy does he bring? Just all those things.
He's a real intense guy. You know, he's all about business. He wants his players to, you know, he demands excellence. He wants you to be the best you can be. You know, toughness, you know, grit, all those, you know, good things. He just wants you to be the best, so, physically and mentally. Yep.
We'll go back here in the middle.
Kingsley, what are some of your goals for this season that's upcoming?
For me, you know, just be a leader on this team, vocally, on and off the field, you know, make some good plays for my team, and just really be, you know, be there for my teammates whenever they need me. Be a role model.
Down in front.
You just talked about being a leader. You're here at SEC Media Days, obviously chosen as one of the spokesmen. Just what entails being a leader for you, for this team, and how can you help the guys, you know, finish strong where it's been the last couple years?
Yeah.
You started great and didn't finish so well.
Yeah, it's, from there is, for me, is really just helping my team wherever they, you know, teammates, wherever they want me to be at, you know. Certain things where I could do better, you know, they'll tell me, if, you know, I'll talk to coaches, it's for me to do better. So really just understanding what, you know, what works best for us, and go from there.
Go back right.
Hey, Kingsley. Big commitment from the university bringing in Jimbo Fisher. I guess how much do the players feel like this might be that next level to get you guys where you want to be competitive in the West and then ultimately competitive nationally?
Yeah, everyone on the team is excited about it, you know, because he's, like I said, Coach Fisher has a proven track record of him winning a national championship. So, you know, he's a great coach. We're all loving what he's done so far, and we're just buying to everything he's telling us to do, and we're going to do from there.
We'll go right back here in the middle.
Kingsley, what was the spring like, and what did you like from there, from your side of the ball, you know, on the D line, and what can carry over to fall camp, and what do you hope to build on, you know, building towards the season?
Yeah, spring was really great. You know, we were learning a new defense, so we just attacked it every day. You know, Coach Robinson has done a great job with the D tackles, and Coach Price has done a great job with defensive ends. And you know, it's not too hard for us. We know what to do in our scheme. It's really simple, so it's been great. We're attacking every day, working hard on our little, you know, techniques and stuff like that. So we did good.
We'll go down in front right here.
Can you break down some of the other guys on the line who you think might contribute well this season?
Oh yeah, there's a lot of young guys. You know, a few guys I've been noticed working hard is Jason Matabuke, Andaria Robinson, Tyree Johnson, Jaden Peavy also. Guys have been really working hard in this offseason. Coach Schmidt has done a great job with us. So, yeah.
Back
hey,
right over here.
Right here. A lot of the big name SEC West running backs have kind of gone on to the NFL now. How do you prepare for a new season of kind of guys that you haven't seen yet in the running game?
Yeah. Being in the SEC, you're going against the best competition in all of football. So, that's nothing really new to us, nothing new to me. You know, used to, you know, going against every game. So that's pretty much it. Yeah.
We'll go in the middle.
Kingsley, you just listed a few D linemen, and Daylon Mack didn't come out of your mouth. A veteran now out of Gladewater was really hyped up. What have you seen from him, and is he really ready to have that breakout year that Aguilera's been waiting to see for 3 years now?
Yeah. Going through workouts, you know, Daylon's been doing really well. You know, I think he's been in his best shape since he's been here. So he's really attacking it. Coaches are really helping him with his diet and stuff he's eating and stuff to help him keep going. He's going to keep doing better from there. I think he'll have a really good season.
We'll go back right.
Hey, Kingsley, the last couple of LSU games turned into a little bit of a track meet, you know, with the offenses really putting up some big numbers. Do you feel that your offense now might be giving this defense a break by staying on the field a little bit longer than they have in the past? And are you excited about the changes and how they complement one another?
Yeah, I feel really excited about how our offense is going to do this season. You know, it's different, you know, from last year. You know, Coach Fish is going to do a little pro-style offense, which will be different, you know, but we're ready to attack it. And we'll see from there. We'll see what goes on.
Down here in front.
How hard was it last year to play with all the rumors and speculations going on? And talk a little bit now about having that behind you where you can just concentrate on football this year.
Yeah. But yeah, like you said, like basically, you know, we're focused on football. The only thing we can do is play football, play hard for our coaches, and like control what we can control. That's that.
We'll go all the way back to the podium.
Guys in a different part of the defense, Donovan Wilson, senior, and Kelder Carper. What have you seen from them in their time, you know, in spring ball, and what are you expecting from them in the secondary, and how much does that help you and what you're trying to do up front?
Yeah, it helps a lot. You know, having a guy like Donovan Wilson, who's a leader that we needed last year, that who hurt his ankle the first game in UCLA, he's a big piece of us, a big piece of that secondary to lead them guys. He's done a great job so far. Because he has that fiery emotion to play back, to play again. So he's leading those guys in secondary. Those guys have been, you know, learning from him and things that they can get better at. So to have him back to help those other guys and young guys is really a big part for us.
We'll go back in the middle.
What's it going to take to get over the 8-win hump? You know, that's been the story for you guys. What's it going to take this year to get over that and get to a better bowl and compete for an SEC West title?
Finishing, you know, attacking the little things throughout the season. You know, everybody wants to win a championship, but you know, you have to worry about the little things. You know, whether attack the little things, attack like go through adversity, the way you go through adversity, stuff like that. How are you going to take care of your body throughout the season? You know, are you going to maintain that throughout the whole season? So all those little things that play a role, you know, help you get through that.
We'll go right here in the middle.
The SEC is tough enough, especially the SEC West. When you throw a game like Clemson on your schedule, what do you think about playing a game like that?
Clemson's a really talented team. You know, they have an amazing front seven. You know, Christian Wilkins, Dexter Lawrence. You know, that Klein Ferrell, these guys are really can play. You know, I have major respect for them and what they do. It's going to be a fun game. Can't wait for it.
Go right here.
Kingsley, when you start the season this year, what's going to be the first difference you think people are going to see in this football team? What's going to be the first change you think we'll see?
People playing for each other. People playing for each other, for sure.
All right, we'll go to the last one down here in front.
You know, Kingsley, did you feel like that was a problem last year where guys weren't playing for each other at times? I mean, why do you think that's going to be a big difference this year?
That's not really what it was. It's just something I feel like we would do better, for sure. You know, little things like that. So, yeah, pretty much.
All right, thank you, Kingsley.
Thank you.